Hi everybody, welcome to day two of our isolation series. Today I'm going to lead you guys through a conscious relaxation and then a sort of quicker invigorating of the same muscles that we've just relaxed. So I personally like to either lay down or sit down when doing this. I'm going to be sitting right now, but if you can lay down, I would highly recommend. So you're going to start by getting into a comfortable position, usually on the floor, preferably on the floor, and you're going to close your eyes. And I'm going to start at the top of our head, and you're going to start to scan, see what's touching the floor or not touching the floor. Are you wearing clothing? Where is it? Where is that clothing touching? Is it providing any pressure? Do you feel a breeze on your head? And you're going to start scanning down through your face. See if you're holding any tension in your jaw. If you are, start to relax that. It's okay if your jaw comes open, your mouth comes open. Just start scanning down. And you come to your neck, which might not be touching the floor, but it's most likely holding some tension. So really start to see those muscles and see if you can ask them to release. Your head might drop to one side if you're laying down. That's okay. Make sure not to re-tense any part of your face as you're scanning down and working down your neck. Come to our shoulders and our arms. These, even if you're sitting up, you'll probably have something touching the ground. If it's as little as your fingers or if it's your whole arm, if you're laying down, start scanning first to see what's touching the floor. Is that comfortable? If it's not comfortable, maybe adjust, maybe move your arm, turn it in or out. Take it out of a fist, let your fingers unfurl. Once you have identified where everything is touching, start to relax it. Feel where you're holding tension. Is it in your fingers? Is it in your elbows or your shoulders? And take it out. Feel yourself become heavier against the floor. And we'll continue this scanning and this release through our lower back, all the way down into our legs. And start with our legs in the same way that you just did your arms. See where each part of your leg is touching the ground. Is that comfortable? Do you need to adjust your feet, adjust your hips? Don't bend your knees, make sure that they're straight, and start to release any tension. I tend to hold some more tension in my ankles, so I would release them. See if your hips will then release and they'll fall open a little bit. Feel your lower body, like your upper body, sinking into the floor. Feeling it completely release. You really want to be focusing on tension. We're not holding tension in every aspect of our body at all times. So you just want to find those places that are and really focus on releasing them. And then if by releasing that one area, another area begins to hold tension or discomfort, you can wiggle, you can release that until the whole area, whether it's your leg, your arm, or your back, feels completely heavy and relaxed. And then we'll come to our toes and just feel the energy being released through the tips of our toes. And then stay in this position wherever you're at, and take three deep breaths. That third deep breath, Bring your attention back to the tips of your toes. And just begin to open them, maybe wiggle them a little bit. Start to move the rest of your foot. And that will naturally lead into your ankle. You flex. Pulling, you roll that ankle a little bit. And then as you're feeling that energy return to your feet, try not to hold, try not to pinch that tension in, but let it flow upwards to your knees. And you can keep moving your feet. When you begin to move your knees. And as you're doing this, similarly to how your feet will very easily lead into the ankles, the knees will lead into movement of the hips. And your hips will start to bring some movement into your pelvis. And this movement doesn't have to be super fluid. It could even just be, you know, bending at the hips, pushing back, or even a little bit more free and wiggly. Find where, now that that energy has been released and is being brought back in, what needs to be moved. And then you'll slowly come up to your stomach, reach your chest, shoulders, fingers, and then up to your head, your neck. You want that energy. Once you've reached your head, maybe begin settling the energy at your toes, and your knees, and your hips, until it's all just coming out from the top of your head. Here, you've really woken up your body. You can go into any practice, whether it's yoga or dance or workout. Thank you.